Welcome to my YouTube channel, and we are back again with the most important questions for Prelim 2020. Let's begin with the first question for the day. Consider the following statement with reference to Koi Geotextile. Koi Geotextile will be used for the construction of rural roads under the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. Geotextiles are permeable fabrics which are typically made from polypropylene or polyester. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. A. Both. B. One only. C. None. D. Two only. So, the correct answer here is A. Both. Alright. Now, this particular piece of information was in news because National Rural Infrastructure Development Agency has announced that Koi Geotextile will be used for the construction of road under this scheme. And why Koi? Because Koi is 100% natural fiber which is obtained from renewable sources. Just like coconut husk, alright. And Koi Geotextile is naturally resistant to rot, molds and moisture and is free from any microbial activity. Besides, it is totally biodegradable and it protects the land surface and promotes quick vegetation. Besides that, it also helps in soil stabilization and can dissipate the energy of flowing water and absorb the excess solar radiation. So, and also, please note, this particular scheme is a centrally sponsored scheme, alright? And the funds will be shared in the ratio 60:40 between the center and state. Except for the 8 northeastern states and Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand, where the ratio would be 90:10. Alright, moving on to the next question. Consider the following statement. First, the Rajiv Gandhi Nyay Yojana is a central sector scheme for the production of Rabi crops to small income farmers. Second, under this scheme, the fertilizers are supposed to be procured from registered government companies only. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. A. One only. B. Two only. C. None. D. Whole. So here the correct answer is C. None. Both the statements are incorrect. Now the reason being, Rajiv Gandhi Nyay Yojana is launched by a state government, that is Chhattisgarh. So it's a state initiative, and it will ensure minimum income availability to the farmers through direct bank transfer. Now, also please note, it will help in the production of kharif crops. All right, just like paddy, maize, or sugarcane. So, this is very important. And besides, the second statement is also incorrect because there is no such provision in this scheme. And one thing it's to be noted here is that it is estimated that 90 lakh farmers will benefit from this scheme, and the government has allocated 5,756 crore in the budget 2021 for this particular scheme. Now, this scheme was launched on May 21, which also happens to be the death anniversary of our former Prime Minister, Mr. Rajiv Gandhi. And a very key feature of this scheme is that the government is going to provide incentive money, that is outstanding bonus, at the rate of rupees 15 per quintal based on the quantity of sugar cane purchased through cooperative sugar factories. Alright, moving on to the next question. Which of the following statement is or are correct? Agricultural Produce and Livestock Marketing Act allowed for the establishment of a livestock market. Second, this act seeks to have involvement of local authorities such as Panchayati Raj institutions. Third, a dual license will be applicable to the whole of state of Rajasthan to the private traders. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. A. 1, 2, 3. B. 3 only. C. 1 and 2 only. D. 2 and 3 only. So, the correct answer here is... Please, you can pause the video and mention your answers in the comment section below. So, the correct answer here is C. 1 and 2 only. Alright. Now, please note, the correct answer is C. 1 and 2 only. Alright. Now, the reason this particular information was in news is because recently the Gujarat government has promulgated an ordinance expanding the purview of this particular act to include the livestock in it. So, this will basically provide a better access and income opportunity to the farmers. Now, also local authorities are involved, like the Panchayati Raj institution, because they have a very ground understanding of the local markets, and also they run the periodical markets and the rural hut program also. Okay, and the third statement is incorrect because no such provision is given to the private traders. This scheme will provide a single license which will be applicable to whole of the state for irrespective private or public trader. All right, and One thing needs to be noted here is that private entities can set up their own market committees or sub-market yard, and it will basically provide a competition and offer the best possible remuneration to the farmers for their produce. Alright, moving on to the next question. Under the Atmanirbhar Abhiyan, government is promoting beekeeping as a part of its aim to double farmers' income. Second, the Economic Advisory Council has set up a beekeeping development committee under the chairmanship of Vivek Debroy. Select the correct answer using the quotes given below. A. Both. B. One only. C. None. D. Two only. So, the correct answer here is A. Both. Now, both the statement here are correct. Now, this was in news because a webinar was conducted by the National Cooperative Development Corporation, alright, on the theme Sweet Revolution and Atmanirbhar Bharat. Now, the objective of this was to popularize scientific beekeeping as a source of livelihood for landless, rural and small marginal farmers, alright. And this will basically add to their agricultural income and also promote horticulture and enhance agriculture in India. Now, the government has allocated 500 crore towards the beekeeping under the Atmanirbhar Abhiyan, and the National Bee Board has created 4 modules to impart training in 30 lakh farmers, and also they are financially supported by the government. Alright, so moving on to the next question. Which of the following statement is or are correct? First, the global energy demand is projected to fall 6% in 2020 according to the World Energy Statistics Report. Second, it is expected that advanced economies will experience the greatest decline in energy demand in the year 2020. Select the correct answer using the quotes given below. A. Both. B. One only. C. None. D. Two only. So, the correct answer here is D. Two only. Now, the reason your fourth statement is incorrect because the global energy demand is projected to fall by 6% in 2020, and this particular provision was given by the Global Energy Review Report. Okay, and please note that the International Energy Agency releases this particular report, and including the World Energy Statistics Report. Alright, I'll repeat again. The International Energy Agency releases the Global Energy Review Report along with the World Energy Statistics Report. But this particular provision that the demand will fall by 6% is given by the Global Energy Review Report. Okay. And also it is expected that this will be the steepest decline in percentage term and also in the absolute terms. And all fuel except the renewables are set to experience this particular contraction in their demand. And also it is projected that this will be the worst impact than it was during the 2008 financial crisis, and it will reverse all the global energy demand that was done over the last 5 years. Also, in India, the energy demand would decline for the first time following the low demand growth rate that had happened in 2019. Now, it is very obvious the demand will fall down because of the ongoing pandemic also. And with the global oil demand falling down, the global coal demand will also be projected to decline by 8% because of lack of electricity demand. And this indeed is followed by the global electricity demand being declined by 20%, alright, during the period of lockdown that had happened. So, that's that. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following statement is or are correct? A. Geographical indication is used by an enterprise to distinguish its goods and services from those of the other enterprise. Second, a trademark is a sign which indicates the product has certain characteristics that are due to that place of production. Select the correct answer using the quotes given below. A. One only. B. Two only. C. None. D. Both. So, the correct answer here is C. None, because both the statement here are incorrect, alright. Now, basically a geographical indication tells the consumer that a product is produced in a certain place and has certain characteristics which are due to that place itself, okay. And please note that the geographical indication tag is valid for a period of 10 years and it can be renewed from time to time for a further 10 years period. And typically, such a geographical indication conveys an assurance of quality and distinctiveness, okay, which is essentially attributed to the place of origin. And any association, producer, organization can register themselves as a proprietor. Now, the statement 2 is incorrect because a trademark is a sign which is used by an enterprise to distinguish its goods and services from those of other enterprises. Okay, it gives its owner the right to exclude others from using that particular trademark. So please note that. Moving on to the next question. What do you understand by the term Anita, which was recently seen in news? It is a radio telescope which is used to detect ultra high energy cosmic ray neutrinos. Second, it is a digital currency which will not be issued in large amount for public use in the short term. Third, it is NASA's commercial crew program which will fly two astronauts on SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft. Fourth, none. So, the correct answer here is 1. Okay. Now, basically, before I move further, I'd like to pause here and tell you what neutrinos are. Okay. So, they are basically high energy particles that pose no threat to us. And they freely pass through our bodies almost every day, okay? And also, please note here, they pass through the most solid object, okay? Now, neutrinos constantly bombard our Earth, okay? And rarely do they interact with any matter. But if they do, they smash into an atom and they produce a shower of secondary particles. Now, these particular secondary particles are easily detected. Hence, this allows us to probe into the where did they come from and all of the other research that will be taking place. Now, please note that recently also in Tamil Nadu, this is important from your current affairs perspective, there was a neutrino laboratory that was supposed to be set up in Tamil Nadu, but it was not given environmental clearances because the people in that particular area were very opposing of this particular project, since Tamil Nadu itself is a region where it is highly, there's a lot of biodiversity in that particular region, a lot of fertile land. So people are very apprehensive about this particular project being set up there. All right. So yeah, so coming back to yours, so it is Anita is an instrument, is a radio telescope, sorry, which is used to detect ultra-high energy cosmic ray neutrinos from scientific balloon flying over the Antarctic. So Anita is the first NASA observatory for neutrinos of any kind, alright? And it involves an array of radio antennas which will be attached to the helium balloon and will fly over the Antarctic sheet, alright? And that's that. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following statement is or are correct? First, event bot is a malware which steals personal financial information from Android phone users. Second, malware is a software designed to perform an unwanted illegal act via the computer network. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. A. Both. B. One only. C. None. D. Two only. So, the correct answer here is A. Both. Now, both the statement here are correct. Now, please note that event bot is actually a Trojan. Now, Trojan is classified as a malware because malware has many types. It has virus, then you have bots, okay, etc. Now, recently this was in news because Computer Emergency Response Team of India has issued a warning against a new malware called event bot. Okay, and this particularly cheats victim by secretly attacking their computers or their phone operating system, and most essentially the is important because it targets money transfer services and financial applications. Now, what exactly is a Trojan? It's a program that generally impairs the security system of a computer. Now, Trojans are used to create backdoors on computers belonging to a secure network so that hacker can have an access to the secure network. Now, basically, what it says is that it is a program that allows outside access into secure networks. Theek hai? So, please note that. Now, moving on to the next question. Recently, which of the following country has classified the organization Hezbollah as a terrorist organization on its soil? First, France. Second, Russia. Third, India. Fourth, none. Now, the correct answer here is fourth, none. Because recently, Germany actually had classified this particular organization as terrorist organization. Now, what exactly is Hezbollah? It's basically a Shia Islamist political party and a militant group which operates in Lebanon and is based in Lebanon. Okay, and this organization was founded by the Iranian efforts in 1980s. To aggregate Lebanese Shia groups, okay, and most recently it is being used in the ongoing Iran and Israeli conflict as a proxy for Iran. Okay, moving on to the last question for the day. Tikri Pehra is a community policing practice in which of the following state of India? A. Maharashtra, second Delhi, third Uttar Pradesh, fourth none. So, the correct answer here is fourth, none. Now, this was recently seen in news because this particular practice is followed in Punjab and Haryana mostly, okay? But this was in news because of the ongoing pandemic. People from the Jhakar district have been practicing this community policing where villagers guard the particular village, okay? So, that's it for the day. And for more information on our various courses, please visit our website www.aishas.com and please like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.